Okay, KJ Nuri. I'm going to try and make a tutorial of the rumba by Paco Cepero, Amuleto, or Amuleta, I guess. Amuleto, and just the tremolo part. So I'd like to use the video as a way to illustrate how I think about these kinds of passages when I'm trying to lift them or pick them up by ear. So what may seem like it's a little bit of a challenging task may not actually be that hard, or at least in my opinion, if you are able to listen in a specific way or in a careful way, I guess. It's not something very fancy or complicated, but I feel that it helps me. And by the way, I may not have the best quality video or audio because I'm going through some sort of a transition with my gear and my software, so still not very sure about how to set things up and tweak them for the best possible outcome, but bear with me. So, enough talking. So the way it will go is when you have a tremolo piece in general, you're going to hear the bass, then the treble part. Something like that. I mean, I suck at doing tremolo without the bass. I all of a sudden don't know how to do IAMI. But you get the idea. So the tremolo is, I don't think of it as a unit when I'm trying to pick it up. I think of it more if I want to get really, or try to get as accurate as I'd like to with picking it up and getting the correct notes, like how the original sounds. I try to break that down into the bass part and then the treble part. So when you listen, I think it's easier for you to listen to this or listen for this rather than to be trying to listen to an entire thing and put it together. Listen to just the bass, and then, I mean, write it down, I guess, so you don't forget. And then listen to just the tremolo. You're gonna listen to. Write down just that melody on the trebles. And then combine the two. And that's how you'll, in my mind, get the most accurate representation. So I'm gonna go through it live with you in the video just for the sake of illustrating what I'm talking about. But I mean, the tremolo, I think, roughly, I mean, without spending too much time on it, because I think he probably never plays it the same every single time, but it's based on these chords. So you have a capo on the third fret. It's just the usual E minor key, I guess, for a rumba. And he does the tremolo on C, D, and then D with this here, and then back to C, and then B7. Notice he uses this fingering here, I guess. And then, so I hear him play at this point, at one point. These notes. So that's how I finger it. Instead of here or just here, I do a small barre by collapsing the finger this way from here to here. Okay? So that's it. It's really simple, really straightforward. I mean, it shouldn't take more than a few seconds to figure this part out. So it roughly sounds like this. Thank you. roughly it. I really did not spend more than a few seconds to just figure this out, okay? You can spend a couple more minutes and then get it down exactly to the nitty-gritty, but I think that defies the purpose of the concept of this video, okay, rather than the accuracy of the notes. So I'm just gonna play the actual tune and then try to go with you to see if you can identify the way I was saying what the basses are and then what the treble is doing and then put them together. So here we go. So it's around 49. Okay, let's see. I have it slowed down with VLC, just nothing fancy. So here we go. I hope you can hear it. So what I heard here is, okay, again, again, and then you notice here he does. Let's see that one more time quickly. So here. You heard that? So he doesn't actually play. He plays da-ra, da-ra-ra. Okay? And like I said, I don't think he's really being super accurate with it. And then so. Okay, so one more time. So that was the bass. So now let's try to do the same thing, except focus on what the trebles are doing this time. Forget the bass. So listen. So you heard bass. That's the melody. So if you wanna, like, this D here is sort of like a passing note. Da, 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 da. Right? So you have to be very precise with the tremolo, I guess, to get this note to be played at exactly the right stroke of the IAMI. So I think. So this is being played at the M, I think. So it's I A M I. Okay. Or something like that. I mean, it's. Let's try it again. Or maybe it's actually like this. So in that case, would be like this. Sorry. And then the transition would happen between here. But again, it's not as important as the accurate notes themselves. It's more the concept I'm trying to illustrate here. So let's go back and listen to the treble part one more time. So here we go. So you hear, so there's this as well. Listen to it again. So the timing, I mean, is maybe not exactly symmetrical like that. So again. Listen to what the treble is doing. So he also does this. Okay. Let's hear it one more time. So that's the part where he does also. I think I was having a tough time with it, because he actually makes it easier by, instead of doing this like awkward timing with by keeping it straight like this while going like ascending with this hammer on pull off embellishment, I think he makes it easier by just playing this and then ta ra 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 instead. So yeah. It's a little bit tricky actually with that ascending legato part, but again, it's I think this video is not as important for you to figure out the particular, like 100% exact way of how he plays it, because I think every time he plays it a bit differently. But the concept is more so that you try to get an idea or an approach of how you can take this apart. So listen to the basses, write them down, listen to the trebles, write them down, put the two together, and then you'll get exactly what it sounds like, the way that he was playing it note for note, I guess, if that is what you're trying to achieve. But I think in general, the tremolo is based on those chords, and it's not supposed to be overly complicated, and it should sound something like this. This helps. It was a valiant attempt, but thwarted. Good luck.